Right, so let's be honest about this. You're helping the patient by perhaps making sure the medicine's right for them, but also that in turn saves NHS money.
Yes, it does. Yeah, yeah, and also reduces GP time and reduces the amount that we're spending on medications in general in practice.
Yeah, Lyndsey, as the nurse here, again, you'll be doing things, I guess, that many people will probably expect to see a GP for, but they're channeled to you. Do you ever get pushback from patients? I don't want to see the nurse. I want to see a doctor.
Not particularly. I think that's more the advanced practitioners that come to see. They would do prescriptions for acute illnesses and things like that. For me, I see a lot of patients with long-term conditions, so I can build a rapport with them and I'll try and get them to manage the illnesses a lot better.
So Vicky, your practice manager, we established that, didn't we? So what's your overall job is to come in here every day and make sure people are funneled in the right direction, which I can imagine is complicated, because I'm intrigued. I do want to talk about patient pushback, because I've been there myself. When somebody tells me I can't see a doctor and I think I need one, I stop giving them the
decision. It's not often we see, but we have implemented the care navigation system, so we triage every call in the morning. And make sure the patient's being seen by the right clinician.
That must be, because I know Rowan Bridge played a tape out on our report, it was here at that 8 a.m. moment. Who's doing the triaging? Because again, I know for a fact that patients, who are you? Who are you to say that I can't be going through there? So who has that frontline job?
It's the reception team. They've all been training. So they do know what they're talking about.
Can he get a bit hairy?
Yes.
So do they have management techniques to deal with difficult patients?
Yeah, this is calm and professional, and they know the right things to say, and it's all about getting the patient to see you.
Yeah. I mentioned right at the start that any GP surgery, we're trying to have a smile through it all, but it is a stressful environment. I'm thinking, now I'm that receptionist, I would work if I triage someone out and to see the GP and they had something wrong with them that is there any kind of collective responsibility there for it's a big decision to say I don't think you really need to see a doctor, isn't it?
It is, but we have safety net in place and the receptionists are trained to deal with what the patients are in for, and you always try and fit them in somewhere even if it's not that day.
It's interesting because you're talking about being a professional. I'm a radio broadcaster, but we've all been patients once in a while, so we all know what we get like. And Emily, you kind of alluded to this earlier on, patients getting to their habits, don't they? They you know, they want to see the same doctor, they see about the same thing. And Emily, they'll come to you. I was in a GP's the other day actually, and a woman went to the counter, got a prescription, came back 10 minutes later. You've not put this in it, you've not put that in it. And people, even if not doing them any good, kind of want the same medication. So that must be a difficult process to have sometimes.
Sometimes. I think it's just about being honest with patients. So when we're making changes to their medication, especially if it's for a cost-saving purpose, actually explaining that to the patients and explaining, look, we're doing this because it's saving the NHS. This is the reason for it. The majority of patients actually take that quite well. I think they don't like it when you change things without letting them know, and don't like it when you change things. But we're very open about why we're doing it.
And Lyndsey, we've only got a minute or so left, but just from you, when you're dealing with patients, are you often saying to them, look, it would really help yourself if you just walked out and you cut down the place from 20 to 10, are you kind of like an advice centre?
Absolutely, yeah, definitely.
And I don't want you to diagnose the whole of Bolton in 59 seconds, but are there any problems that are prevalent in this area of Bolton? I don't know, but I think you see time and time again. I don't know, type 2 diabetes,
yeah, lots and lots of type 2 diabetes, also COPD, breathing conditions.
All right, okay. And so you're saying cut down a bit to people and they'd rather have a bit of treatment, would they?
Yes.
Hopefully, I mean, by doing programs like this, we say you three ladies are part of the front line, and hopefully everyone's listening to this around the country. So when, it might not all be patients here, but when they go to their doctors next time, it might be a little more simple. Right, I'll let you go and have a cup of tea. Thank you.
Thank you.
That's more stress than putting a thermometer where you shouldn't. I'm glad that's over. I'll let you go.